Today is going to be a max range test on my Muck Pet Ninja. So this one has two batteries. They're identical. They're interchangeable. I could put that one there and this one here. So I'm going to do this range test with just one battery turned on. So each battery has its own on-off switch. So right now they're both off. And if I try to turn it on, nothing happens. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to turn the front battery on. And now it's coming on. So I'm gonna do this entire test. There are five modes. I'm gonna do it on mode three. Mode three will get you going about 20 miles an hour. And max range, if you're going too fast, the whole equation for power or resistance is a whole bunch of coefficients that are like your cross-sectional area, the air density, the coefficient of drag, but then it's velocity squared. So if you're going 10 miles an hour, 10 squared is 100. If you're going 20 miles an hour, it's 400. If you're going 30 miles an hour, it's 900. So really, I want to do it around the 20 mile an hour mark. I've ridden bikes a lot. 20 miles an hour is a good cruising pace if you're, you know, putting your head down and putting like 230 watts out about. So that's what I'm going to do. 20 miles an hour. See how long it takes me to drain one battery out, and I'll let you know. So for this whole test, I'm not going to pedal at all. I'm just going to be using the throttle. And my feet will be stationary. I don't want to put any additional power into this because then it's not really a good test, because I might pedal a little harder or not as hard as other people. And this is the baseline. If you just want to be lazy and cruise, then this will be how far you can go. Starting off, we're in mode three. So I want to show you over here. There are zero means you have to pedal. And if you pedal, you will get no power. You got eco, eco, normal, normal, and then sport. Five is the highest. So at five, you can go about 30 miles an hour. And then everyone down is about 5 miles an hour slower. So I'm gonna be at three, going 20 miles an hour until the battery dies. I'm gonna go until the bike stops moving. I'm not gonna go until the energy bar gets down to one. I'm gonna go until it will not go any further. And then what I'll do is I'll stop, let the battery settle, and try one more time on the throttle. If it goes, I'll go a little further to get a total distance. I'm gonna use this odometer, but I'm also gonna set my bike trip like GPS on my phone to get that mileage too, to see if they're even different from each other, this compared to GPS. So that's the test. I'll let you know how far we go. 1.5 miles in, full throttle, 19.3 miles an hour. And I'm just doing about a 1 mile loop. I'm gonna do it over and over. No real steep hills, just pretty mundane. That's it. Two laps in. Two more laps, 5 miles in. Still shows full power, but that can't be right. I did watch the voltage, and the highest current I saw was 15, and the lowest was 2 going up and down hills. 6 laps in. Finally lost 1 bar on the battery. So the battery bar is all over the place when I go up and down hills now. It was anywhere from 2 down to 4 down. We've got 9 miles. One bar just came back and it went away. So who knows, but we're gonna go until there's nothing left. 2 more laps in, down to a half, but it keeps going up and down based on the hills. We're averaging about 1/2 mile an hour slower, maybe almost down to an entire mile an hour slower on everywhere we're going. So the voltage has dropped a little bit, but we're still moving. 12 miles in, or 12 laps, 13 miles. The battery bar has gone down to only 3, but then up to only down to 6. So it's all over the place, but we're still going. I think when the battery bar gets down to 2, I'm gonna go back over to my house where there's a track and do the rest of it on flat ground. 15 miles, going. Laps, 17 miles. Getting down there. Four bars. 18 laps. Three bars. All right. 25 miles. We're down to one bar, but it's going between one and two, depending on uphill or downhill. We're actually on a flat sort of downhill. We're going about 2 to 2.5 miles an hour slower than we were at the beginning, but still 25 miles, going 20 miles an hour with little hills up and down, pretty darn good. I've done 26 laps. I'm gonna head back to my house now and do the rest on the track at the elementary school. But overall, pretty awesome. About 3 or 4 miles per hour slower on average. All right, battery bar is flashing. Battery bar is flashing. We're going 10 miles an hour now, 9 miles an hour, 27 total miles. Pretty darn good. I'm not giving up yet. And it is dead. I'm full on the throttle. We are stopped. Ugh, my hand hurts. 27.6. Energy bar completely empty. I'm gonna let it sit here and let everything cool down and settle for about 30 seconds, and then I will try the throttle again. It's been about a minute. My hand is still super tingly from holding the throttle the whole time, but it's sitting at one bar, so I'm gonna see if it goes at all. Oh! That's full throttle, and we're going barely fast enough to even stay up. So 2 miles an hour, one. Nope, that's it. That's all she wrote. 27.6 miles, but I also did a GPS and it's showing 28.2 miles. So 28, we'll round it to 28. And now what I'm gonna do is turn it off, turn the battery off, turn this battery on, turn it back on, and we are back to full battery. All right, now we know. Alrighty. Oh, hey, oh, hey. All right, so I spent the last hour and 45 minutes riding around my neighborhood. There's about a 1 mile loop, a little bit of up and down. It's pretty much a little downhill for half, a little uphill for the other half, no really flat areas, but I had it in mode 3. So modes 1 and 2 are eco modes. Modes 1 gets you like 10, 11 miles an hour. Mode 2, around 15 miles an hour. I was in mode 3 because in all reality, if I need to get somewhere and I'm gonna use this, I'm not gonna go 10 miles an hour for 25 miles. So I set it to a realistic commuting speed, 20 miles an hour, and just went full throttle. I didn't stop a single time. Well, I stopped at 3 stop signs and then the loop had no stop signs. So I was able to do 26 and a half of the 28 miles nonstop, a little bit of up and down, but I just kept going. So the battery readout stayed full for like the first 5 miles, and then it would fluctuate back and forth all the way down. And then when it got down to 1 or 2, it started going a bit slower. I was watching the voltage as well. It started out in the low to mid 50s, and then by the end it was in the low 40s. Current draw was pretty much the same the entire time, but as voltage drops, your watts or voltage times current, or voltage times amps, so you're getting less watts as your voltage goes down and current stays the same. Started out going around 20 miles an hour, 20.2 or 3 on the flats, and about high 18s, low 19s on the little bit of uphills,
And then by the end, I was only going like 16 on the uphills and 18 on the flats and downhills. When I finally got back to my neighborhood here, it was going about 8 miles an hour and then down to 2-3 miles an hour, and then it just stopped. When I let it rest for a minute, it got one bar back, but then when I tried to go again, I went maybe 30 feet at 1.5-2 miles an hour, and then it just died. Turned the entire thing off, switched the batteries, and I was back to full, and it was, if I'm just riding around, I'm gonna keep both batteries on, but if I have somewhere far to go and I'm not sure if I'm gonna make it back, I'll ride one battery out, switch it to the other battery to come back. I think if I were to just go to a flat track and go at the lowest mode one, I could probably do 50 miles, but that would be super boring, 5 hours of riding. And then the other thing is I weigh 215 pounds and I was going up and downhill. That is gonna take a lot more power than someone a lot lighter and on flat ground. And then the other thing was it was not very windy, but bigger cross section. If I were to tuck down or something, I probably could have got further. So I'm not saying that the 120 mile max range that they advertise on this is not doable. I'm just thinking it's not realistic for everyday riding. And what I did today, I would consider everyday riding, minus the fact that I didn't stop very often or at all. But it was ups and downs, 215 pound person riding 20 miles an hour. That's pretty realistic. And to know with both batteries, you can go more than 50 miles like that. That's pretty incredible. So that's what this video is. Super happy with it. Great bike. The seat, not the most comfortable to sit on for an hour and 45 minutes, but no bike seat is all that comfortable, to be honest. Even my road bike, it gets miserable. I'll stand up and get out of the saddle pretty often on that too on my longer ride. So overall, great bike. I'm gonna recharge it so I can go ride some more later. I do have the other battery, but I like to know I have a full tank, if you will. So I'm going to fill up the one I used all the way down to zero. As far as heat, battery did not heat up much at all. So this is the one I didn't use. It's nice and cool. This one maybe like 3 degrees warmer. The motor itself is probably pretty warm. Actually, not that bad at all. Not warm to the touch. For constant use, for an hour and 45 minutes, nothing really getting hot to the touch is pretty impressive. So again, what I might do is go out and ride it the way I normally ride it, through the grass, up and down hills, in mode 5, as hard as I can. I would be willing to bet, I think the next challenge is gonna be how few miles can I get and use the entire battery. My goal is maybe 8. If I ride it really hard, just through grass, through dirt, full throttle the whole time, going uphill, it's going to be pulling basically full current at full voltage at the highest mode. So it'll be fun. So anyway, Muck Pit Ninja, awesome bike. I'm really glad I got it. I still love it, still looks cool. I got my lock on it, so when I do take it places, I can lock it up so no one's gonna steal it. And that's it. Cheers.
It's over!